Sri Ramakrishnaya. Letters of Swami Vivekananda. Arise, awake, onward. I only tell you this, that whoever reads this letter will imbibe my spirit. Have faith, onward, Swami Vivekananda. Letter number 58, continued. To be concluded today. We must work among the English educated young men. Tyage naike amritatvam anushuh. Tyage naike amritatvam manushu. Through renunciation alone, some rare ones attained immortality. Renunciation, renunciation. You must preach this above everything else. There will be no spiritual strength unless one renounces the world. Why are Babu Ram Premananda and Yogin Yogananda suffering so much? It is owing to their negative, their self-abasing spirit. Their self-abasing spirit. Tell them to brush aside their illness by mental strength, and in an hour it will disappear, i.e. the Atman self smitten with disease. Off with it. Tell them to meditate for an hour at a stretch. I am the Atman. How can I be affected by disease, and everything will vanish? Think, all of you, that you are the infinitely powerful Atman, and see what strength comes out. Self-depreciating? What is it for? I am the child of the infinite, the all-powerful divine mother. What can disease, a fear, a want mean to me? Stamp out the negative spirit as if it were a pestilence, and it will produce, and it will conduce to your welfare in every way. No negative, all positive, affirmative. I am, God is, everything is in me. I will manifest health, purity, knowledge, whatever I want. Well, these foreign people could grasp my teachings, and you are suffering from illness owing to your negative spirit. Who says you are ill? What is disease to you? Brush it aside. Viryamasi viryam, balamasi balam, ojosi ojos, sahosi saho maidhe. Thou art energy, impart energy unto me. Thou art strength, impart strength unto me. Thou art spirituality, impart spirituality unto me. Thou art fortitude, impart fortitude unto me. The ceremony of steadying the seat, asana pratishtha, that you perform every day when you sit down to worship the Lord. Atmanam achidram bhavayet. One must think of oneself as strong and invulnerable, and so forth. What does it all mean? Say, everything is in me, and I can manifest it at will. Repeat to yourself that such and such are Atman, that they are infinite, and how can they have any disease? Repeat this an hour or so on a few successive days, and all disease and trouble will vanish into naught. Yours ever, Vivekananda. Letter number 59, return to Alasinga Perumal, 541 Dearborn Avenue, Chicago, 1894. Dear Alasinga, your letter just to hand. I was mistaken in asking you to publish the scraps I sent you. It was one of my awful mistakes. It shows a moment's weakness. Money can be raised in this country by lecturing for 2 or 3 years. But I have tried a little, and although there is much public appreciation of my work, it is thoroughly uncongenial and demoralizing to me. I have read what you say about the Indian papers and their criticisms, which are natural. Jealousy is the central vice of every enslaved race, and it is jealousy and want of combination which cause and perpetuate slavery. You cannot feel the truth of this remark until you come out of India. The secret of Westerners' success is there is this power of combination, the basis of which is mutual trust and appreciation. The weaker and more cowardly a nation is, so much the more is this sin visible. But my son, you ought not to expect anything from a slavish race. The case is almost desperate, no doubt. But let me put the case before you all. Can you put life into this dead mass, dead to almost all moral aspiration, dead to all future possibilities, and always ready to spring upon those that would try to do good to them? Can you take the position of a physician who tries to pour medicine down the throat of a kicking and refractory child? An American or a European always supports his countrymen in a foreign country. Let me remind you again, thou hast the right to work, but not to the fruits thereof. Stand firm like a rock. Truth always triumphs. Let the children of Sri Ramakrishna be true to themselves and everything will be all right. We may not live to see the outcome, but as sure as we live, it will come sooner or later. What India wants is a new electric fire to stir up a fresh vigor in the national veins. This was ever and always will be slow work. Be content to work, and above all, be true to yourself. Be pure, staunch, and sincere to the very backbone, and everything will be all right. If you have marked anything in the disciples of Sri Ramakrishna, it is this: they are sincere to the backbone. My task will be done, and I shall be quite content to die if I can bring up and launch 100 such men over India. He, the Lord, knows best. Let ignorant men talk nonsense. We neither seek aid nor avoid it. We are the servants of the Most High. The petty attempts of small men should be beneath our notice. Onward. Upon ages of struggle, a character is built. Be not discouraged. One word of truth can never be lost. For ages it may be hidden under rubbish, but it will show itself sooner or later. Truth is indestructible. Virtue is indestructible. Purity is indestructible. Give me a genuine man. I do not want masses of converts. My son, hold fast. Do not care for anybody to help you. Is not the Lord infinitely greater than all human help? Be holy. Trust in the Lord. Depend on Him always, and you are on the right track. Nothing can prevail against you. Let us pray. Lead, kindly light. A beam will come through the dark, and a hand will be stretched forth to lead us. I always pray for you. You must pray for me. Let each one of us pray day and night for the downtrodden millions in India who are held fast by poverty, priestcraft, and tyranny. Pray day and night for them. I care more to preach religion to them than to the high and the rich. I am no metaphysician, no philosopher, nay, no saint. But I am poor. I love the poor. I see what they call the poor of this country, and how many there are who feel for them. What an immense difference in India. Who feels there for the 200 millions of men and women sunken forever in poverty and ignorance? Where is the way out? Who feels for them? They cannot find light or education. Who will bring the light to them? Who will travel from door to door bringing education to them? Let these people be your God. Think of them. Work for them. Pray for them incessantly. The Lord will show you the way. Him I call a Mahatman. Him I call a Mahatman, great soul, whose heart bleeds for the poor. Otherwise, he is a Duratman, wicked soul. Let us unite our wills in continued prayer for the good. We may die unknown, unpitied, unbewailed, without accomplishing anything, but not one thought will be lost. It will take effect sooner or later. My heart is too full to express my feelings. You know it, you can imagine it. So long as the millions live in hunger and ignorance, I hold every man a traitor, who, having been educated at their expense, pays not the least heed to them. I call those men who strut about in their finery, having got all their money by grinding the poor wretches. So long as they do not do anything for those 200 millions who are now no better than hungry savages. We are poor, my brothers, we are nobodies, but such have been always the instruments of the Most High. The Lord bless you all. With all love, Vivekananda. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Tat Sat. Shri Ram Krishna Arpanamastu.